Morning, guys. I'm Siobhan, a second year medical resident. It's a gorgeous snowy morning and I wish I could spend it outside. But today I am going into work to do a 24-hour call shift. So here we go. I've actually given up on the sidewalks. It's so incredibly snowy there. To the hospital. Step one is meeting up with the team who was here overnight and finding out what issues there were, hearing about the new patients who were admitted to the team. Then I'm heading down to the emergency department and I'm responsible for admitting all the patients to the internal medicine team during the day. Hey, the team.
Hey.
Morning, guys. How's it going?
Good.
Okay, there's a lot of scrubs. This tells me there's a lot of people on call.
Yeah.
You guys are all on call, eh?
Yeah, right. The whole
Friday,
team.
Sunday.
The whole team. Okay, here we go.
Yeah.
It's a tough night.
Not too bad. Actually got some sleep.
Oh, right. That's excellent.
Even though it doesn't look like it, but yeah, actually got like 4 hours and, you know, a couple ward issues, but otherwise pretty easy.
Okay, so why don't we start with some of the night issues, and you can tell us what happened with the team. So you can see some of the signs from last night. The old pizza boxes, looks like someone was doing some teaching on the board over there. But overall, it looks like it wasn't too busy of a night. I think that's because there was a big snowstorm last night and patients probably didn't want to come in unless it was really urgent. The question is, does that mean today is going to be super busy? So let's see what happens. I don't know, I'm just going to check out the board and the emerge and see how many are probably coming our way for admission. Oh, here we go. Hi, this is Siobhan, the SMR. Mm-hmm, yep. Yeah, do you mind just getting another repeat ECG? And I'll be in to see them in just a little bit. Perfect. Great, thanks very much. Okay, bye. So before going to see a patient, what I typically do, as long as they're stable, meaning their vitals are within normal range and I'm not concerned that things are progressing very quickly, in which case I go and see them right away, I'll often just take a look at previous notes, get a sense of their past medical history and write it down, look at their home medications, and look at the lab work that's been done by the emergency physicians. That already frames in my mind some concerns so that when I go and see the patient, I can tailor my history and my physical exam to these issues, and then if something might flag my concerns, I have a better sense of their history to as a context, I suppose.
Okay, just saw that patient with the chest pain, and I'm thinking it's probably something called pericarditis. That's the thing I'm most likely concerned about. That's actually when you get inflammation around the sac of the heart, called the pericardium, and it can get irritated, so painful. And it tends to be painful that when people sit forward, it feels better, and it's worse when they're lying down, and that's pretty classic. So there are lots of things that can cause it: medications, infections, cancers, autoimmune conditions. So I'm gonna send off a whole bunch of blood work, and probably most of these won't come back until tomorrow or the next day, and we'll try to figure out what's going on.
All right. Hi, this is Siobhan, the SMR, returning a page. Oh, hey, I didn't know you were on today. Yeah, I'm good, not too busy. Sure. Oh, okay. Yeah, no problem. Is the patient stable? Their vitals? Perfect. Thanks. So that was a resident from psychiatry, and they've admitted a patient who's now having some electrolyte abnormalities. So they're hoping we can review the electrolytes. They'll take care of the mental health side, we'll take care of more of the physical medicine, and together hopefully we'll make the patient feel a lot better. And it's so nice because I actually know this resident from medical school. It's nice when you know people around the hospital.
Okay, so just got a third consult. This is a patient who's incredibly dizzy and apparently vomiting a whole lot. So I finished the first consult. Second consult, I've got the orders in, but I haven't finished the note. And I should probably go and see this patient first before finishing that note. And then hopefully there'll be a chance to finish up all the typing and documenting. So I just saw this patient with vertigo, so the feeling of the whole room spinning, and the patient looks so much better than when they first came in, and I'm sort of wondering if they can just go home and don't need to be admitted to the hospital. That being said, as a resident, I don't have the power to send someone home. I have to run it by my staff, so I'm going to give them a call and see if they agree with appropriate follow-up to have this patient go home now. Just got called by one of the residents. Turns out one of the patients pulled out a feeding tube, and so we're just going to have to go and put that in now, otherwise they can't get their medications overnight. Just got called about a patient who's extremely short of breath, so I'm just heading up to reassess them right now. Okay, so I think this patient aspirated, meaning they sort of inhaled either some food or maybe it was just saliva, and it went down the wrong way, and that made it a lot more difficult to breathe. And you can see this on the x-ray. So this patient's going to be going to a more monitored setting, meaning they can monitor their heart rate, their oxygen levels, and there's just more nursing to patient ratio because this patient's sicker. So they're being transferred there now, and I'll go and follow up and see how they're doing in a couple of hours. Back to the emergency department now. Okay, just got two more consults, and now that it's 4:30, I think I'll just recruit some more help from the other residents that are here today. They should be done with their patients up on the ward, so I'm gonna page one of them to come down and see one of the patients. Hi, can you please page team B medicine? Yep, 37037. Thanks. Okay, bye. Okay, so we'll just wait for them to page back.
Hey, Siobhan.
Oh, hey! Oh my gosh, I can't believe it's 5 p.m. already.
Me neither.
It's nice to have you back on.
No worries, happy to take the pager.
Yeah.
How's the day? Busy?
It's been not too bad. I feel like it's just been steady, been able to catch up. There's nothing pending, there's
nothing
no extra
pending?
Consults
okay.
Now. So.
Awesome.
And the eMERGE, I don't know, like, it's kind of steady, but it's not super busy right now.
Not super busy? Okay, well, let's not jinx it.
Yeah, exactly, I don't say anything. Okay, good.
Perfect, I'll call you if I need you.
Sounds good, thanks.
So since a second SMR, senior medical resident, joined me at 5 p.m., there are two of us on, and the eMERGE actually isn't too busy, we've decided to divide the night. So right now, I'm actually heading up to my call room at 9 p.m., totally unheard of. So maybe I'll get a little bit of sleep, and then I'll go down around 4 a.m. to take over and do some consults at that point. But of course, he'll call me if things get busy at any point, or if they get overloaded and I'll just go down a little bit early. That's no problem at all, but this is so nice. Get some sleep. It's a good room, but it's freezing. Man, what temperature is it? Oh no, it's set here, but it's here. I fear that it actually might be broken. Oh no, okay, let's crank it. Now I'm gonna wake up boiling. Okay, so now the priority is food, having some stir fry, and then take a nap for as long as I can. All right, it's 4 o'clock. Apparently we just got 3 new consults, and they look on the sicker side in terms of breathing, and so I'm just gonna head down to the eMERGE now and help out doing some of these consults. Man, it is so cold in here. Just finished my last note, 5 minutes to spare. Tim Hortons is now open, so a breakfast sandwich is in my very near future. It's just about 10 a.m., leaving the hospital now. Wow, so we admitted 20 consults overnight, so I don't know, a busy, steady sort of night, not really all that unusual, so we didn't really get slammed after the storm. So if you want to see more videos about what it's really like to be on call in the hospital as a doctor, don't forget to subscribe and then like this video. And here are a couple other ones that you can check out that you might enjoy. Otherwise, I'll be chatting with you guys next week. So, bye for now.